Lord, we give you praise, we give you honor. Lord God, I'm asking Holy Spirit that you would direct my words tonight. Be in my hands, my feet, and my belly. I thank you, and I'm asking Holy Spirit that we have a teachable spirit, that we are wise as the most Sunday in Abahaya, in everything that we go about and do and say. We thank you for it in advance for what you're speaking to us tonight, in Jesus' name. And we said amen.
Amen.
Amen and amen. That's a perfect place to praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Chapter number 2. We're going to be beginning our reading at verse number 6. The word of the Lord God says, "For thus says the Lord of hosts, once more, it is a little while, I will shake heaven and the earth and the sea and the dry land, and I will shake all nations, and they shall come to desire all nations. And I will fill this temple with glory, says the Lord of hosts. The silver is mine, the gold is mine, says the Lord of hosts. The glory of this latter temple shall not be greater than the former, shall be greater than the former, says the Lord of hosts. And in this place, I will give peace, says the Lord of hosts."
Wow, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. If you're taking any notes, the title is "My Ladder."
My God.
Shall be greater.
Hey!
My ladder.
My God.
Shall be greater than my former. Thank you, Lord God. In the book of Haggai, and as I'm going to take my time and as the Lord God allows me to explain the chapter, what they're talking about is a temple, is a house. Amen? We're talking about a temple. But the Lord God wants us to realize that we are also considered a temple. Amen. Amen. That, you know, this is a twofold. We're talking about a physical temple, and we're also talking about your temple, your body. In 1 Corinthians, the Bible talks about that the body, that we are the temple of the Holy Ghost, that we house the Spirit of the Lord.
Yeah, Lord.
The Lord God says that there's no building that can hold him. So that means he resides in us. We hold with the temple of the Holy Ghost. Amen. That's why we've got to be mindful as to how we can keep our temple clean. Amen.
Yes,
but I want you to understand that the Lord God is speaking in Haggai chapter number 2. The Lord God says, and he spoke, and he said, "Once a little while, I'm about to shake the heavens and the earth." There's about to be a shaking of some things taking place. People of God, that Lord God is trying to tell you that your ladder shall be for better than your former. And ladder, you're like, some of you, I don't understand ladder. We're not talking about a ladder like you climb up. We're talking about L-A-T-T-E-R. And as I love to define words, and I'm true to my fold, and I'm true to who God called me to be, I'm defining the word ladder. Ladder means to occur nearer to the end. To occur nearer to the end. Nearer to the end. Mm-hmm. And another definition is that it could be the second part. Hallelujah. I don't know about you, but I'm ready for part 2. We didn't got the to second. Chapter number, but let's get to chapter number 2.
The
I don't know about you, but I know before I get into the word, you know, most people like to be on the first string. Am I right? When you want to do something, you want to be the first. You know, when y'all play sports, you don't want to be the one on the bench, you want to be the one on the court. And talk to me now. You know, you want to be the first string, but I want you to know one thing about the second string, that they're ready and they're fresh.
Amen.
I'm going to tell you, see, they weren't given the opportunity, but when the Lord God puts you on the front, you know how to operate. Thank you, Lord God. So it's nothing wrong with being the first line up, that you're the next in line. The Lord God said it's called part 2. See, part 1 was the other year. Part 1 was the year before, but 2019 is part 2.
Amen, amen.
I saw it coming.
Yes,
glory
yes.
Hey, your ladder shall be greater than the former. People of God, the Lord God is talking to you, and he's telling us, and he's speaking to me, as this word is for this house, and it's for your house, that the glory of the latter temple shall be greater than the former.
Amen.
That means your ladder, your future is going to be so much better than what your past was.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I don't know what your ladder, what the former days may have held for you. I don't understand. I don't know. You may have gone through some things. Sometimes people keep looking at your past. Your former is your past.
Amen.
You know, everybody had a past. You know, you did something, things that you shouldn't have done. You had a past. But the Lord God said, "I'm not too concerned about where you came from. I'm concerned about where you're going."
Amen.
Yes. And that's what I like about the Lord. The Lord God said, "I give you a clean slate."
Yes,
I tell them what's concerned about where you're going. You know, you gotta embrace the ladder.
Amen.
Tell your neighbor, ladder.
Ladder.
Tell your neighbor, it's a ladder.
Ladder.
That's right. That way they need to prepare themselves. The Lord God is trying to tell us something today, people of God, that the Lord God is telling that your latter days are going to be better than your former days.
Amen.
That means the things that you are about to experience will be so much better than what you've experienced already. Thank you, Lord God. You may have had some mistakes, and may have had some hang-ups and some problems, but the Lord God said that was a part of your past, your former.
Amen, amen.
But your latter will be better than your former.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Lord God.
Yes, Lord.
Your latter shall be greater. Thank you, Lord God, than what you've been experiencing. People of God, the Bible tells me in the book of Ecclesiastes. You remember we were talking about Solomon? Solomon wrote the book of Ecclesiastes, and he said, the end of the matter is better than its beginning.
Yes, Lord.
All right.
Ecclesiastes 7. He talks about that the end of a matter is better than the beginning. And I say that because we all had a beginning. Talk to me, sanctuary.
Right.
We all had a beginning. We all had a start. Amen.
Amen.
And somebody, and we may have made some mistakes in our beginnings, but the Lord God says the end of the matter is better than its beginning. So that means how you're going to finish is way better than how you started.
Amen, yes, amen.
God.
Yes,
so you may
Lord.
Have started
yes,
messed
Lord.
Up. You may have started out cursing. You may
yes,
have started
Lord.
Out doing the wrong thing. You may have started out being disobedient. You may have started out not doing right dealings, not speaking right, talking right, not even behaving right. But you're going to end better than what you
yes,
started.
Lord.
Thank you, Lord
hey,
God.
Lord.
And you are children of God. That's a promise
yes,
from
Lord.
The Lord that your end shall be better than your beginning.
Amen, amen. Amen.
The Lord
thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord God. You know what? You may not have been a person of prayer in the beginning, but now that's all you want to do is pray.
Yes, yes Lord.
You see, your latter days are so much better than your former. You see, even as a farmer, I'm just going to preach a little bit in the name of Jesus. Because see, whenever you plant a garden, you got anybody like to plant? Anybody like to plant any garden? Thank you, Lord God. Like to plant a plant? Hallelujah. You know what? Farmers have a tendency when they plant, they know how to wait patiently. They know how to wait patiently. Because see, if you put a seed in the ground, all right, y'all, you may not plant, but when you was in kindergarten, they gave you that pinto bean, you remember
that?
Put that in a cup with them little toothpick, and they told you, they put that in the window with your name on it.
Yes.
And the moment that it was right, you would go bring that to my
yes.
But how long did you have to wait? Now, those of us who were impatient with your bean, your bean never grew because you was all...
Always picking at it.
Where is it? Where the green is? Never. But those who know how to be patient
amen.
And know how to wait, they just let it sit there.
Uh-huh.
And surely enough, it sprung up.
Amen.
The Lord got saying, but it took some rain to get that.
Yes, Lord.
It took a little rain. It took a rain. It took for you to water it. Amen.
Yes, Lord.
And the Lord God says, you've got to wait for the latter
Jesus.
Rain. See, a lot of us, we're grateful when the former rains, it's like the autumn rain. The first rain that you get. And there's something wrong if you want to get things right now. I don't know about you, but I want the latter rain.
Amen.
I want what God has. See, right now, you may be being blessed, and God's probably blessing you, but don't move too quickly. Thank you, Lord God. I want to get all that my daddy has. Because see, if you move too quickly, you're just going to get the form. You're going to get just what I had for you last year.
Amen,
you're
going
to miss out what I have for you in 2020.
Yes, Lord. Hey, God.
You're going to miss. If you move, you're going to miss.
Yes, Lord.
Come on.
Hey, God.
If you move, you're going to miss. You're like, wait a minute. But the Lord God said, see, you got to wait for it. You know, we see, you're getting some rain right now. And there's nothing wrong with the rain right now. You thank God for the rain. The Bible tells you, ask for rain in a time of rain.
Amen.
When it's raining, rain, God. Whenever
amen.
God starts raining down blessing, rain, rain, God. Rain,
amen.
Rain. Ask for blessing and ask for rain in a time of rain.
Amen.
But God says, I not only want to give you rain for today, I want to give you rain. We're talking about spiritual. Come
amen.
On.
Amen. Amen.
We're talking about blessing. Not only for today, the Lord God says, but wait for the latter rain.
Amen.
Wait for the rain that I have for you in 2020. Wait for the ones that I have for you in your futures. When you
yes, Lord.
Do. Don't get too anxious. Don't be quick to move. Don't be quick to, the Bible says, be anxious
just
for nothing.
Nothing.
But in all things, in prayer and supplication, make your requests known unto the Lord. Now, before you move and before you do, the Lord God said, just wait.
Yes, Lord.
And the Lord God said, surely enough, you're about to get
thank
the
thank you, Lord.
Rain.
Amen.
I want you to know that's the last bit of blessing before your stuff really comes sowing out.
My God.
Yes, Lord.
That means it probably was going to be this high, but because you waited for the ladder, it's going to be this high.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Lord God. See, if you would have waited, see, if you move too quickly, you're going to have a little bit of
air. Uh-huh. Preach it, Pastor.
All right, you just have a little bit of air over. But if you wait on God's timing, you
yes,
have
Lord.
Enough parking.
Yes, Lord. Hey, God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
You don't have enough room. You have to wait. I don't know if I have enough room, Pharaoh. Oh, you
Jesus.
Have to wait because you waited for the ladder.
Yes, Lord.
I've been waiting on it, but
yes,
I'm about
Lord.
To send the ladder in.
Amen,
the
amen.
Ladder in.
Thank you, Lord.
That rain that right before you begin to spring
I
up.
I thank you in advance,
Lord. And you know that ladder rain makes you bigger than,
yes,
what, you,
Lord.
Than what you anticipated. Because see, you're like, oh, Lord, God, I'll take the promotion. I'll take the promotion. Thank you, Lord God. Yeah. The Lord God said, but just wait. You wait on the ladder rank. Not only will you be in the promotion, you'll get the money and the schedule that you want.
Jesus! Hallelujah!
God.
Hallelujah!
You wait and not only get the class, you get the class and the schedule that you want.
Yes, Lord.
But you don't mind. Wait. That's the ladder rank. The Lord God says, I know that you think it's good right now, but God says, I got something better for you.
Amen.
Yes, Lord God.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord. Even as we go about today, even for this house,
yes,
the Lord,
Lord
God's trying to tell you that the glory of the latter temple,
yes,
shall be greater,
Lord,
than the former.
Yes, thank you.
And see, you must understand, in this passage in Haggai chapter number 2, there's a lot that's going on, people of God. There's a lot that's going on. And I'm talking about the spiritual house. There were some things that were taking place because the temple was no longer in beauty. It was taken in Babylon. It was taken in captivity. And the reason why I'm saying that, if you read the word and if you read the whole book of Haggai, it's not a big book.
Mm-hmm.
They were in captivity. And all of a sudden, they began to wonder, who remembers what it used to be like? You know, you have people saying, you know, I remember when it was this, and I remember when it was that. And the Lord God says, you know, we remember that, but he said, I want you to understand, I got something better for you.
Yes, man. Lord.
He said, some of us are trying to,
yes,
hold on,
Lord,
to what we used to have.
Yes. Better.
You know what, boy, I remembered. And the Lord God says, you're too busy reminiscing on what you used to have. You don't have room for what I'm trying to give you.
Jesus. Preach it, Pastor.
You must understand.
Preach
it. Making, you know what?
Room.
That was good back there. Thank you, Lord. But I'm looking.
Yes, Lord.
Yeah.
Make room.
I know you got something better.
Yes, Lord.
Better. I thank you, Lord God, that we're talking about the latter rain. The Lord God is telling us, even in the word, you see, these individuals that were in this chapter, that the word of the Lord is saying, he said they were getting a little discouraged. Come on now. And this is for the people of God, the saints of God. You know, you've been in a house for so long, you sometimes just get a little discouraged.
Amen, amen, amen.
You just get a little discouraged.
Preach it, Pastor.
Sometimes you go through the motions. Mm-hmm. All right,
mm-hmm.
Now, come on.
Preach it. Yes, preach it. Preach it.
You do this, you do,
yes,
that.
Yes, yes.
You do this, and you do that, and then you go to your house.
Amen, yes. Yeah, uh-huh. Amen.
It's true.
Amen.
And you know what? And the Lord God is trying to tell you, and as he was speaking to those people, he said, if you just wait a little while.
Jesus.
The Lord God says, I'm about to shake something.
Yes, Lord.
I'm about to shake your,
yes,
mind.
Lord.
What you were going through, what you were expecting God to, because I'm about to shake some
shake
things
it, Lord.
Up. I thank you, Lord. God, I don't know about you,
yes,
but if
Lord.
You're sitting next to somebody, tell
shake
me God,
it,
I'm about
Lord.
To shake some things up for you.
God is about to shake something up for
you. Thank you, Lord God. He said, God's about to get you out of that spirit of complacency. He's about to shake some things up, because some of you are just too comfortable. God's about to rock your world.
Yes, Lord. Hey, God. Yes, Lord.
Get you out of that. You're like, wait,
yes,
a minute.
Lord.
Wait a minute.
Hey, God.
Thank you, Lord God, because he said, I have a ladder blessing for,
yes,
you.
Yes, Lord.
I'm about to rain. He said, I'm about to shake you.
That's shake why it, Lord.
He said, for a little while, I will shake the heavens and the earth.
Thank you, Daddy.
And the Lord God's trying to tell us as he's speaking throughout the word, we know about the latter days. In the book of Job, how about you remember the book of Job?
Mm-hmm. Amen, amen.
Amen. The Lord God ministered to Job, and even in Job 8, I believe. Thank you, Holy Spirit. 8:17. You know I love to walk through the pages. Job 8:17. It's not that far. Keep walking in. Job 8:7. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Wow. Wait a minute, Lord. That's a powerful one too. He said, wait, yeah, are you there? Job 8. There we go. He said, though your beginnings were small, your latter end will increase abundantly.
Hey, God.
Though your beginning was small,
amen,
your latter end is about to increase how abundantly. I'm going to tell you that the Lord God is speaking to you in this house today.
Amen.
He's trying to tell you that though you started out small, though you may have started out, I'm just a little prayer warrior. I'm just a little servant of the Lord. I just love the Lord. And the Lord God said, you may have started out small, but I'm about to increase you abundantly. The Bible said that God said he can do exceedingly and abundantly above all you can ask or think. He's telling you right here, though your beginning was small. I want you to understand, don't despise. God bless you. The days are small beginnings. Don't despise those days. That's in Zechariah chapter 4, verse 10. The Lord God said, don't despise the days of small beginnings. Well, you might as well just get the message because the Holy Spirit is flowing tonight in the name of Jesus. Don't despise the days of small beginning. A lot of times whenever you say, if you're starting a new business, you're about to start something new, you're about to start a new class, you're about to start a new adventure, something that the Lord got laid upon your heart and it doesn't seem to be doing what you anticipated for it to do. Talk to me. I got any raw people in the house?
Amen, amen.
Thank the Lord God. The Lord God told you to do something and you're doing just what he told you
amen.
To do. But you haven't seen the fruit of that labor.
Amen, amen.
My God. Yes, Lord.
Amen.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Yes,
Lord.
My God.
Not just yet.
Amen.
Not yet.
Not just yet.
Not yet.
I'm about to preach myself happy of this.
Yes, Lord. Hey, God.
Not just yet.
Mm-hmm.
You started out small.
Amen.
You started out just doing a little bit. You may say, well, Lord, I thank you. I have a one bedroom. I have
yes,
one
Lord.
Thing. I just have that. I'm using it to make it in reality because I don't know about you, but not everybody living in mansions yet.
Amen. Amen.
We got something with our name on it. You may have something really small. We're going to say something smaller than what you would like. But don't get discouraged. Don't be despised by, you know, someone else today. They have something large. It's all right. That's for them.
Amen. Yes, Lord.
That's
amen.
Their time.
Amen.
And I rejoice with
yes,
you.
Yes, Lord. Oh, amen. Yes.
Praise God.
Yes.
And yes, you got a, you know, five with three.
Yes, Lord.
Upset. Praise the Lord.
Amen. Amen.
I pray you got a maid to clean it.
Yes,
amen.
Lord. Hey, God.
Yes,
Lord.
Thank you, Lord God. Because you're there. What? So, you know, we thank God for it. But if that's your desire, the Lord God says, don't despise the days of small beginning. Because he said, as you are, treat what you have like it is a palace.
Yes, Lord. Hey, God.
Pick that up.
Yes, Lord.
The floors are gold, they are gold.
Yes, Lord.
Keep it. You keep it the way that you would a palace.
Amen.
The Lord God said, keep it as though it were as large as you want it to.
Yes, Lord.
Because the Lord God said, don't despise the days of small beginnings.
Yes.
He said, you may have started out small, but God says that you're about to be abundantly. Thank you, Lord God. You're about to increase abundantly. That means large quantities, people of God. Thank you, Lord. Not enough room to receive.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Lord. Hallelujah. You know, every time I back pound and I pound, well, that devil gets so nervous.
Yes, Lord.
God. You may think it's just something of tactic. I call it spiritual warfare.
Yes,
because,
Lord.
See, he may think that he has somebody afraid up in it. So I pound him to let him know I'm alive and I'm here. And my latter days will be very much greater than my former.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Lord God. And you need to be encouraged and know that though your beginnings were small, you may have thought that you were a great player or a great, you know, at what you do, and nobody recognized your name. You were in class and everything, you were on your job and you did everything right, and nobody recognized you.
Amen.
Anybody ever been there before?
Oh.
Anybody ever been there?
Yes,
not
Lord.
Even recognize you. You're the only one in the family that does everything.
Dang, everything.
Nobody knows your name. They just know you as you pass so quickly. They just think they think that's your job.
Uh huh. Yes, Lord. Preach it, Pastor.
I got a name, Robin.
Preach
you
it.
Do so much that
preach
if
it.
You don't do it, they actually get mad at you.
Uh huh.
Yes. And it's not your job.
Preach it.
You're just doing it out of the kindness
yes.
of your
heart. Yes.
But if you don't do it, they want to get upset with you. Like really? You want to not do that? You're not gonna fold the towels, really? You're like, they're not my towels. I'm trying to help you out.
Yes, Lord.
I'm making it nice and plain. We can
write. Uh-huh. Amen.
You can put
amen.
That everywhere where it needs to be.
Uh-huh.
Yes, Lord.
You're not the shepherd yet. You're the chef boyardee for everybody.
Uh-huh.
You're Betty Crocker for the neighborhood.
Yes. Preach it, Pastor.
You're just supposed to be cooking for you and yours, because you and yours are gonna eat some cereal.
Yes. Yes.
Steak.
Yes.
They got a buffet spread you gotta get to. What's on the menu tonight?
Hello.
That is so true.
Yes, it is.
And the Lord God's trying to tell you, you're starting off small, and yes, nobody may have recognized that you're doing it.
Amen.
But the Lord God says, your time has come.
Amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Hallelujah.
The Lord God saying that, you know, you're starting out small, but the Lord God says, I know your name.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
I seen your works. How they move on Sunday. I seen your sacrifice. And the Lord God says, I'm about to rain on you.
In the name of Jesus.
I'm about to shower you.
Yes, Lord.
On you.
Yes,
in
Lord.
In abundance in the name of
yes,
Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
Not
thank
just
you, Lord.
No sprinkle. We're talking about a downpour.
Yes, Lord. Lord.
Thank you, Lord God. He said, why? Because abundantly increase you.
Amen.
He said, because you started out small.
Thank you, Dad.
You were doing it out of the kindness of your heart. It was out of a sacrifice. I work as I work unto the Lord.
Yeah.
As I work unto the Lord.
Amen.
That just because I get a check, that don't mean the check run me.
Amen. Yeah, preach it, Pastor.
I work as I work
yes,
unto
Lord.
The Lord.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
I put extra time, not because you, because I know my Father's going to bless
you. Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord God. So you must understand that. And the Lord God is trying to tell you that even though things may not look like it right now, but God says that your latter days are about to be better than your former days.
Yes, Lord.
The glory of the Lord God is about to be revealed in you, through you.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, the glory of the latter house. Hallelujah. We're going to take that thing straight up in the book of Joel.
Yes, Lord. Hey, God.
He said, I told you my sons and my daughters.
Yes, Lord.
To prophesy.
Yes, Lord.
They said, that more son than ever, even your
yes,
maids.
Lord.
My God.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord God. The Lord God said, yes, there was a great move of God back in a time gone on. There was truly a great move. Hallelujah. There was a great move in the 50s. There was a great move in the 70s. That almost Sunday. There was a great move. There was even a great move in late 80s and early 90s.
Yeah.
And there were great moves, great shifts, and great flows of the Holy Ghost. And people were wondering, where is revival? I don't know about you, but I've sat back and I said, where is revival?
My God.
Because if you're the same God yesterday, today, and forevermore, then I know that you're something. The Lord God says, he said, I was just waiting for the latter rain. My God, thank you, Lord God. We're about to get a downpour in the name of Jesus. I'm here to tell you, denominational walls are coming down. Yes, Lord God. He comes in and I'm happy. No longer will anybody be wearing a badge of this and a badge of that. We're just children of the Most High God. Serving the Lord. And
yes,
what a
Lord.
God. One spirit in the name
yes,
of
Lord.
Jesus. You know, the Lord God said, that's what I'm waiting for. He said, that's the latter rain.
Amen.
Amen. The sons and the daughters. You're going to find that in the... You think churches are popping up.
Jesus.
He's pouring out.
Yes, Lord.
Because what one won't do, God says, I'll send another.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord. God's no respect of person.
Yes, Lord.
He's no respect of
yes.
person. Thank you, Lord God.
Yeah, God.
You have to make that clear because, you know, like, oh, no. He said, my son, Emma, we're living in the latter days.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
That's why the great outpouring. Thank you, Lord God. And you know what? Ask for the rain when the time of rain.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I get? When the Holy Spirit is moving, say, move, come on, move, Holy
yes.
Spirit.
Yes.
Let your glory fall.
Yes.
He said the
yes.
glory
yes.
of the former house cannot even compare to what's going to in the latter.
Yes,
that
Lord.
That means you have sinned.
Yes, Lord.
You
yes,
may
Lord.
Have thought you have seen or heard of some miracle. You're about to hear and see
yes,
things that
yes,
happened.
Lord. Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
In the name of Jesus.
Been documented just
all right. Oh, hallelujah.
You know why they haven't been documented? Because it wasn't even called that before.
Yes, Lord.
Amen.
Hey, God.
Oh, hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
Eyes have not seen.
Ears have not heard.
Seen it until the heart of
what
God's about to do.
Yes, Lord.
The latter rain is about to fall in the house in the name of Jesus. The latter rain is about
yes,
to fall
Lord.
In your family. The latter rain is about to fall
yes,
in the things
Lord.
That pertain to you. You have not even sinned the best of it just yet. The Lord God said, if you don't mind waiting for the latter.
Hey, girl.
He said, what you're experiencing right now is just a taste.
Thank you, Lord.
It's just a taste. You're like, oh, wait a minute, God. Thank you, Lord God. Yeah. I'm praying that this is blessing you because you have to say,
hallelujah.
The Lord God's
thank
trying
you,
to
Lord.
Tell you that, yeah, he said the latter
ooh.
Is going to be so much better than the former.
Yes,
because
Lord.
As I was mentioning, thank you, Holy Spirit, as I was mentioning about Job, you know, he lost everything in the beginning.
Everything.
You
amen.
You know the story. He lost yes. a lot in the beginning. Yes. Amen. Really, he lost everything. And he almost lost his mind.
Amen.
Preach it. Because when you can have everything coming
yes,
up against
Lord.
All your kids gone, all your money gone, all your, you know, all your resources gone, and you got people that's close to you tripping.
Yes.
That'll make you
preach it, Pastor. Amen. Amen.
That'll make you want to lose your mind.
Amen.
And then you mess around. Then you mess around and got some friends and they want to act up for you.
Yes, Lord. Yes.
He only had three.
Three?
Yeah. Three heads was acting foolish.
Yes, Lord. Yes.
You must have did something wrong.
Yes, yes.
You must have did something wrong. You, so I want you to know that that was very hard for him. But see, that was a small beginning.
Amen.
It was small for him. He didn't even realize it. Like some of you, I pray I'm preaching you happy up in here as well. Because you need to understand the Lord. I said, you're not even realizing. That's just small what you're going through.
Amen.
People
amen.
Can't stand it. They don't like it. It's small. It's small. Yeah. You know, they're not paying attention to what, right. You know, what you're talking about. They're belittling you. Yes. Small. That's small. The Lord God said, just wait.
Amen.
So you wait till I start raining on you. Amen. Till I start raining on you. You're not only going to want to be close to you. You're going to be like, they're gonna be, you remember me?
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
Yeah. Hey. They're going to remember me? All of a sudden, they start name dropping. Oh, yeah, I know so-and-so.
That's
really?
Yeah.
Now you want to know my name.
Amen.
Oh, before you couldn't stand me. Hey. Now you remember my first, my middle, you remember my name, what color.
Oh, hallelujah.
You remember everything about all before you was. All of a sudden they got what you got a comma at your name. They got your accolade. They know about your children, your marriage. But before then you didn't know my name.
Uh huh.
See you want to know my bio, but you didn't know I was registered in the heavenly realm.
Preaching fast.
Where's her bio? It's written in the heavenly realm.
Yes, Lord.
Which school did you go to? The school of theology called the Holy
Ghost. Yes, Lord. Hey, God.
Oh, wait a minute. You know, see, your ladder shall be better than your form.
My God.
Yeah, thank you, Lord God. Your ladder shall be better than your former.
Amen, amen.
Your ladder shall be better than your former. You need to understand that what you're going through right now is just temporary.
Thank you, Lord.
It's just temporary.
Thank you, Lord.
It's just a temporary place.
Thank you, Lord.
It's just temporary where you are right now. It's just temporary. Don't get discouraged.
Yes, Lord.
It's a small beginning. The Lord God spoke, and he spoke in that same passage in the book of Haggai. He spoke to Zerubbabel. When he told Zerubbabel, he said, it's just for a little while.
Amen.
It's just for a little while. It's amazing to me that after he spoke to Zerubbabel in the book of Haggai, he turns right around in the book of Zechariah. Mm. And the same word that was spoken again. You know when God speaks twice.
All right now.
Yes, Lord. Yes.
That's called a heavenly echo.
Yes, Lord.
Whenever God speaks twice, it's called a heavenly echo.
Amen.
That means he's confirming his word.
My God.
It may be a different vessel. But it's the same word.
Amen.
Because he spoke to Haggai, the prophet, to speak to Zerubbabel.
Amen.
In the book of Zechariah, Zechariah was speaking the same word that Zerubbabel had gotten. It spoke twice. Just to confirm. And the Lord God said, I'm confirming my word in here today.
Amen.
I'm confirming that the latter shall be greater than the former.
Yes, Lord.
The Lord God is trying to tell some of us that
yes, Lord.
You're doing something small, that things may not look all that good right now, but you got to ask for rain when rain begins
it's
to fall. You're like, well, when is it raining? When that testimony came forth, that was some rain.
Yes, Lord.
Everybody
yes.
Been
yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
You're like, wait a minute. You don't have to
yes.
jump and shout. You're like, I want to get a little bit
of that. Yes, Lord.
Side of blessing.
Yes, Lord.
Yes,
Lord.
Take that. Because that's when it started to rain.
Amen,
see,
amen.
We don't recognize our season. We don't recognize when the Spirit of the Lord God is moving. He said, when he does the stirring of the waters. He said, you want to wait. No, don't jump. You got to move when the Spirit of the Lord God is moving.
Yes, Lord.
Woo.
Yes, Lord.
You must understand that the Lord God is speaking to you. Yes. It may seem small for you right now. But the Lord God said, don't despise that. Because the Lord God said, I have something better for you. He said, those things are starting out small. Ministries are starting out small. Jobs starting out small. What you desire to do starting out small. You know, it's just like a baby. Everything has a baby stage.
Stage.
Mm-hmm. Everybody.
Amen.
Anything that comes out full grown is
amen.
Called not normal.
I preach it, Pastor. Amen. Amen. Amen.
You come out the womb as a pure adult, there's something demonic going on.
Amen, amen.
And if you see that in the natural, like, yes, Lord, there's no way. There's no way a pure adult got, no, Well, how do you think about it spiritually?
Amen.
How do you think about things that you're going through, Amen. Things that you're doing? There's nothing that you're going to do, even if you're walking with the Lord. That goes for the secular realm and the Christian realm. Amen. There's nothing you're going to start. You're going to start off already big. Mm-hmm. Everything starts. You may step into something.